So I'm delighted this morning to be with Piotr. Piotr Ruskinek, I hope I've got your name slightly right, Piotr. I met Piotr I met you a number of times. I know you're quite active on the property scene, particularly in the auction room as well. So if anyone follows you on Facebook Live, they will have seen you at a number of auctions over the last month or two. You've presented at auctions at a number of pin events as well. What you do at auctions, you've also got your own mastery course coming up in June as well. Before we go into any more detail, what made you get into auctions?
I guess I had an experience of auctions from when I started in properties, when I started working for the property company Central London. I'd go to auctions, and I would initially, the way I started is I would canvas for mortgage services. So I would go to people who want the properties, and I would tell them, oh, do you want finance? Can we help you somehow? I wasn't really good at it, but then I moved on to property sourcing and then going to auctions to find properties for clients. And I found auctions to be a really good place to find properties because they are definitive and everything happens within 3 or 4 weeks. And it really helps with getting the deals through the line. And auctions verify buyers, verify sellers. Everything is transparent. And as long as it's a commitment, that deals to be done in auctions.
I was going to ask you, do you look at a particular auction house? I know you've been to Auction House London. Do you look at buying or selling? Is it mostly buying rather than selling at auction? Have I got that right? Or do you do both?
So it's mostly buying at auctions. Basically, like auctions are a place where there's lots of motivated sellers and it's a good place to buy. But at the same time, sometimes I help people sell properties in auctions and I look at auctions as a place to potentially trade some properties. But generally, I focus on buying in auctions and sourcing properties for clients in auctions. And I tend to look at all auction houses in London, but it happens that most of my kind of deals come through two or three auction houses, which is predominantly Auction House London that I work with very closely.
Okay, so Auction House London is one of the ones which you're definitely quite active involved with. So in terms of auctions, for some people, it can be quite a scary experience as well, because literally it's the drop of the hammer. So I know you've got your mastery course, which is aimed at helping people who, you know, may be a bit apprehensive about the auction route. So the mastery course is in June, and it's auctionsmastery.com. So I know you're interested in auctions. I know you're interested in trading and joint ventures as well. Is it possible just to explain some of the things which you've done with other people? It's not necessarily always yourself buying at auction. Is that right? You may buy for other people?
Yeah, that's right. So I usually work with joint venture partners and clients who signed up for my property services. Property sourcing services, and when I find a deal and I know this is something that the person I'm working with would find interesting, then we look into structuring this. So we either can do that as a joint venture, we can do it as a straight sourcing service, and I do most of those things kind of interchangeably. Depends on the client, depends on the property, and depends on exit scenarios, because every property has got a different exit scenario. So we always look at making things work.
Sure. How many auctions would you typically attend in a month? Or there's no typical month?
There's no typical month, I would say. But I go to maybe two auctions a month. And sometimes I go to like no auction at all because there's no need to, like I go to auctions where there is something I'm interested in. Otherwise I can get basically access all the information online, or I can watch it online if need to be. So sometimes there's no need to go to the auction. But I would say auction is a good place to, even if I'm not buying something, it's a really good place for networking, because there's a lot of committed investors there and lots of potential clients or partners, and it's a good place to kind of hang around.
I was going to say, so do you use software? I know my co-host for Wandsworth, Nicholas Marshall, I recently did a Facebook Live at a property which he bought at auction, and he uses a central information group, EIG. Do you use any software yourself?
Yeah, I use a central information group as well. It's really, like as the name says, it's essential when buying in auctions, because it does provide huge amount of historical information on auctions, as well as all the live updates, and it's really a super useful tool for buying in auctions. So I use that, and I use all the other services like Rightmove, Zoopla.
So from speaking to Nicholas about his last deal, he got an alert through a central's information group, because he looks at a geographical area. Do you look at a geographical area? You're quite wider spread, because you've got partners as well, joint venture partners. So they probably have got interests outside of maybe your particular geographical interest. So how does that work with a central information group?
Using essential information. I've got some alerts set up on essential information group, but predominantly how I find the deals is through going through the catalogs and literally looking through every property that's being offered, and then trying to find out just by looking what's the good deal, what can be done with that particular property. So I try to review all the catalogs anyway. And I guess the alerts are useful, but I do things in a slightly different way. So I would review things myself.
Okay. So in terms of when you're looking at the catalogs, is there something which would create an alert? You know, you think, what would sort of like be the top things you'd be looking for to come out at the catalog? Is it the area? Is it the cost? Is it because it's a freehold property? What things would say yes, and what things may say no to you if you see possibly something which says leasehold? Would that put you off?
Not really. So with some of the property, like predominantly what I'm looking for in auctions are freehold properties with multiple units, that's of interest. Then mixed-use properties with commercial downstairs and flats above. Then I would look at some other projects. Basically, I would look at properties if I know that something is potentially of a good value. So I think I've got a pretty good grip of values in London, in each different part of London. And it's easy for me to, because I do that all day long, I look at properties all the time, and I can spot properties that I think are a really good value, or I can spot things where, for example, recently I spot a property which had quite low income, but I knew that the capital value of that property was much higher than the income it was producing. So, and I did a deal there about 6 months ago. So I knew that area, and that deal pretty much stood out for me in the catalog. So it was a leasehold tenanted flat, but there's no rule of what property has to be or what cannot be for me to be, for this property to be interesting.
Pietro, I did promise it would be a short interview. I'll try to make it short, but people, of course, can ask you much more questions when they come to see you at the Wandsworth Property Network on May the 16th, which is a Tuesday evening. It's going to be an interesting evening. You've got the likes of Philip Arnold Auctioneers there as well. You've also got the finance company RDT Invest, designed to help people who are considering buying at auction. In terms of your final remarks, or just focusing on your continuous learning, do you use things like Audible? And if so, do you have any favorite books which you could recommend, or what are you reading possibly right now?
So one of the books that recently I was listening to actually a couple of times is it was the Grant Cardone's book, that's the 10x rule. That was one book, and also Be Obsessed or Be Averaged. And
Say that last book again. I haven't heard of the last book. I heard of Grant Cardone or Cardone. Yeah. I've heard of the 10x rule. I have to admit, I haven't read it. But the other book I've never heard of. The other book is?
Yeah, Be Obsessed or Be Average.
Who's that by?
That's also Grant Cardone.
Okay.
He wrote quite a few books, and I was listening to him on Audible, and his style is not really the same as my style. I'm a bit more moderate than he is, but what I like about his books, especially on Audible, is his energy. Like, he's really passionate about what he does, and I think the message he's got is really empowering, and especially for entrepreneurs and people in properties. I'd recommend those two books.
Okay, that's interesting, because his name's flashed up on my Audible quite a few times, but to be fair, I've also not signed up to his book. So that's really good. Piotra, is there anything we can add? So we've mentioned that you're presenting at Wandsworth in May. We've mentioned that you've got your mastery course in June. Have you got the date already confirmed?
Yeah, so it's going to be Sunday, 25th of June. And so I've got everything confirmed. The venue's confirmed. We've got three guest speakers coming. And it's going to be really a full day packed with content.
Sure. And in terms of the people who are confirmed, am I right in saying it's the likes of Jay Howard? Is that correct?
Yeah. That's correct, yeah. So we're going to have Jay Howard from Auction House London. He's going to be giving the tips on buying and selling properties in auctions. And he's really knowledgeable. He's an auction manager in Auction House London. He's really knowledgeable from not everything kind of inside out. So he's going to be giving insiders tips. And we're going to have Richard Ignatovich, who is a mortgage broker, and he deals with bridging as well. So he's going to be giving a finance talk. And also we're going to have Mahfouz Rahman from Ronald Fletcher Baker Solicitors talking about reviewing legal packs.
Sure. So what Ronald Fletcher Baker I know a little bit more about, because they've presented for me live about 2 weeks ago at my morning meet, maybe even less than that, to be fair, the Central London morning meet. They're going to be presenting or on a panel at the Wandsworth Property Network, and I've also spent quite a bit of time doing Facebook Lives and doing Zoom interviews as well. So I just want to just give a call to action for people out there who are listening to the interview. It's great to have the likes of Piotra or Piop doing an interview with me. Look, I do have a number of interviews lined up with some really interesting people. I know Rick Gannon's one of them, coming up later this year. Harinder Paul as well. I've got a number of Facebook Lives. I'm after April the 20th, because I've got two events next week, 18th and the 20th. Wandsworth 7-year anniversaries on the 18th, Central London Evening Property Meet on the 20th. After that, I'm going to have quite a bit more time to do interviews. So I've got a little bit of a waiting list. As I say, I've got the likes of Rick Gannon and Harinder Paul and Mike Woods. There's a couple more as well. But after that, I'm going to have an opportunity, if you're interested. And I share this interview to about 5,000 subscribers on Twitter, get shared to my LinkedIn account, which has got about 1,800 viewers on my LinkedIn, and other places as well. But I just want to say huge thanks for your time this morning, Piotr. And you've definitely convinced me to give Grant Cardone a go, to say the least. And as I say, the key dates coming up for myself and you, Piotr, in terms of auctions, I think it's the 16th of May. It's the Wandsworth Property Network. It's Tuesday. And I'll be sharing how you can book onto that. And for the latter event you've got coming up in June, auctionsmastery.com. So huge thanks for joining me today. Huge thanks to the listeners as well. So thanks for the moment.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.